Hello student, here it is our question. Obtain all other zeros of the polynomial x to the power of 4 minus 3 square root 2 x cube plus 3 x square plus 3 square root 2 x minus 4 if two of its zeros are square root 2 and 2 square root 2. So for this polynomial, it is given two of the zeros, that is square root 2 and 2 square root 2. We need to find remaining zeros. Since it is 4th degree polynomial, you can see the highest degree is 4. So since it is 4th degree polynomial, it will have 4 zeros. Okay. Already we have 2 zeros. We need to find remaining 2 zeros. Going further, so let us give some name to this polynomial. Let P of x is equals to x to the power of 4 minus 3 square root 2 x cube plus 3 x square plus 3 square root 2 x minus 4. Okay. And given square root 2 and 2 square root 2. Square root 2 and 2 square root 2 are zeros of P of x. Okay. Then x minus square root 2 and x minus 2 square root 2 are factors of P of x. These two will be factors of P of x. So why it is? Let us say, since if A is a zero of P of x, which means x is equals to A, then x minus A is equals to 0. That implies x minus A is a factor of P of x. Okay. If A is a 0 of P of x, then x minus A is a factor of P of x. That is, x is equals to A, then x minus A is equals to 0. So further, x minus square root 2 into x minus 2 square root 2 is also factor of P of x. So product of these two also factor of P of x. Again, why it is? Since 2 comma 3 are factors of 6, let us assume, then 2 into 3 is also factor of 6. 2 3 are 6, 6 divides 6. Here 2 divides 6, 3 also divides 6, then product of these two also divides 6. Okay. So simplify this further. X into x, x square minus 2 square root 2 x minus 2 into square root 2 into x, square root 2 x minus into minus plus square root 2 into 2 square root 2. This becomes 4. Square root 2 into square root 2, 2, 2 2's are 4. So further we can rewrite this statement. X square minus minus 2 square root 2 x are there, here minus square root 2 x are there. So and sum of these, 3 square root 2 x plus 4. Okay. Now this is also factor of P of x. Since it is a factor of P of x, this divides P of x exactly. This divides P of x exactly. So now dividing P of x with x square minus 3 square root 2 x plus 4 to get remaining factors. Once you get remaining factors, from that we'll derive the zeros, remaining zeros. Here P of x is x to the power of 4 minus 3 square root 2 x cube plus 3 x square plus 3 square root 2 x minus 4. We are dividing this with x square minus 3 square root 2 x plus 4. Here first term x to the power of 4 is there, so we need to get first term x to the power of 4 here. For that, x square we need to multiply with x square. So again we need to multiply with this x square, this entire polynomial. X square into x square, x to the power of 4 minus into plus minus 3 square root 2 x into x square. This becomes 3 square root 2 x cube plus 4 into x square plus 4 x square plus 4 x square subtract. So I am subtracting, signs will change here. Plus x power 4 minus x power 4 gets cancelled. Again minus 3 square root 2 x cube plus 3 square root 2 x cube, these two also gets cancelled. Now we left with plus 3x square minus 4x square. So on subtracting we'll get minus x square plus 3 square root 2x minus 4. Now we require here minus x square. Already x square is here, so we have to multiply with negative 1. Negative 1 into x square, negative x square minus into minus plus 1 into 3 square root 2x is 3 square root 2x plus into minus minus 1 4s are 4. Again subtract, signs will change. Minus x square plus x square gets cancelled. Here 3 square root 2x plus minus 3 square root 2x gets cancelled. Here minus 4 and plus 4 gets cancelled. Since it is this is factor of this, anyway it divides exactly. Now this will be our remaining factors of p of x. Since it is factors of p of x, this divides p of x, which means x square minus 1 is equals to 0. Further you can rewrite this, x square minus 1 square is equals to 0. It looks like a square minus b square. So one of the algebraic identity a plus b into a minus b. So by using this we can rewrite this, x plus 1 into x minus 1 is equals to 0. And since a into b is equals to 0, for example if a into b is equals to 0, so either a should be 0 or b should be 0. If you want, product should be 0 except matrices. So in real number system any one of them should be 0. So x plus 1 is equals to 0 or x minus 1 is equals to 0. Further x is equals to plus 1 comes here, minus 1, or x is equals to minus 1 goes here, plus 1. Therefore our remaining zeros are minus 1 comma 1, and all zeros are minus 1, 1, and one more square root 2, and another one 2 square root 2 for this polynomial. Okay, therefore our remaining zeros are minus 1 comma 1, and all our zeros are minus 1, 1 square root 2 and 2 square root 2 for this given polynomial.